Ricky Melvin and Charlie Kiss Breakfast right now. We're joined by the star of The Hunger Games, Mockingjay Part 1 and 2, and Game of Thrones. Give it up for Natalie Dormer! Yay!
Hi guys, how are you? I'm very well, thank you.
Good to see you. Yeah. So, Mel,
can I just say, Ricky's your biggest fan. He's trying to be cool, hold it down like he's Usher or something. But he is your biggest fan.
I was a big fan of the undercut.
You've gone a little bit red. I was a big fan of it.
So let's talk about The Hunger Games. It's out today. Yeah. We're excited. We're big, big fans of this film. Now, how do you prepare for a role like this?
You shave half your head.
I shave all my head down.
It's funny when you have to shave half your head off and you get put in army fatigues and given a semi-automatic rifle. It's kind of no acting required. It's kind of like you suddenly you are the character.
Yeah.
But I thought I was going to have to shave my whole head when I took the role.
Like, seriously.
I took a phone call and it was my agent and they were like, okay, they love you. They need to know if you would shave all your head.
Willing
to do that. And so I was like, I had to give the answer. Well, of course, I want to be part of the Hunger Games. Yeah. I'd be an idiot not to be part of the Hunger Games. So I was like, yeah.
How much of a fan of the undercut were you? Because I enjoyed it immensely.
Really? I didn't know that.
Surprise.
Actually, I turned out to be a massive fan of it.
Really?
I found it really empowering, actually.
I want to know, Natalie, what is more you? Wearing a corset for your BBC show or the total opposite and playing with some weapons?
Cressida's more real me.
Yeah. That's what we like.
I'm more that chick. I was very happy running around in flat boots and like running around with the boys. It made me very happy. Yeah.
What is it like working with Jennifer Lawrence? We've never actually met her. We've never had her on the show yet.
She'd love you guys.
I saw her at a premiere once and she gave me a high five. So she's definitely like a cool chick because she gave me a high five, obviously. But what's she like to work with, like, on set?
She's so much fun. She has a great, you know, when you're working 9 months on a movie, like we shot the two movies back to back, like 9 months, day in, day out, really early mornings.
Wow.
You know, and the energy filters down from like the lead, the top person. Yeah. And she's just a laugh. Everything you've heard about Jennifer Lawrence is true.
Really?
That she's a prankster, that she she tells jokes, that she's really grounded, that she's down to earth, that she's a lot of fun. She is all those
things. Tell her to come see us, please.
Yeah, she'd love this studio.
Natalie, we had Emilia Clarke, who plays Daenerys on Game of Thrones, and not so long ago. Now, she told us a whole load of stuff about the show. She was really, really forthcoming and really forthright and very, very... just really open with us. So I've got a couple of questions here for you. And I'd like you to be as honest, if not more honest, than she was, if you possibly can. You ready?
Jon Snow's dead.
That was my final question. I respect you again.
Okay, well, we know that he's dead, but he hasn't changed his hair, like, in the real world, which means that he could possibly be going back in, because, you know, that's Jon Snow's hair, right? Surely.
Yeah.
Could he be going back in? And obviously the Red Witch and stuff, she can bring people back to life. She fancied him. Is he coming back?
He's been doing his homework, hasn't he?
He's a massive real fan.
I couldn't possibly comment.
All right.
You know.
Did you ever get out of the dungeons? What? It's a valid question.
Do I ever get out of the dungeons? We've all got to have a bit of faith in Marjorie.
Yes,
you know,
yes,
she's
yes,
not
yes.
going to let herself be left in a dungeon, is she?
Right, now, Christmas is around the corner. What is the perfect Christmas for Natalie Dormer?
A lot of cheese.
We all have to ask you about this.
It's not a lie. You'll read a lot of crap on the internet.
Any kind of cheese, Natalie?
You know, I like a put me in front of a log fire with some red wine and some cheese.
And a block of cheese.
I'm very happy. How are you so slim?
Darling. I actually love you. Love a
girl
who likes food.
All right, so Natalie, good luck with the film.
Yes.
It's a pleasure having you here.
Thank you.
I know Ricky's happy.
Thank you.
Make some noise for Natalie Dormer.
Yay! Yay!